the last Mass to be held at St. Ethelreda's Church. This parish has been serving the community for decades, and as difficult as this day may be to many of us, we have to know that God is in control and will never leave or forsake us.
Prepare all God's people for the work of Christian service in order. monster of people, reaching to the very height of Christ's full stature. This is the word of the Lord.
Some of you are unaware of the value of effort
despite countless meetings, promises, letters, promises, proclamations, and yes, more promises. As you end, these items clear the path to today. I do not want to leave, nor do I want you to leave this day without acknowledging and thanking those whose numbers dwindled at the obvious became a reality, to thank them for their effort and diligence. I want them to know that the reward, though not apparent on this day, will be provided for them through the blessing and love and understanding from our real Master, Jesus Christ. Please, as you face the future, and as you make decisions about what and when, and as you return to your own parishes, remember that there are those of us who will never forget and forever be grateful to you, or at least trying. And also, please remember that St. Ethelreda School remains an important entity here on the Southwest side. If you feel the need to continue your assistance and concern, I ask you want to still be associated with St. Ethelreda. I implore you to please direct your efforts to our youth, our students, our future. We will be there, and we will welcome any and all expressions of generosity and participation. We run a paper drive. We have all the newspapers, magazines, whatever. Feel free to grab your classified and just deposit those items in our paper bin. The Lady of the Diocese has decided to start a scholarship fund. What a great day this would be if the collection for today would go into our scholarship fund to really give it a lift for the upcoming school year. To which it has increased, and we know that our diocese is not giving money to schools who must be self-supported. Wouldn't it be great, Father Vanessa, if today's collection could be used for our scholarship? I close with this reminder that I present to our students each and every school year. Good, better, best. Never let them rest until your good becomes better and your better becomes better. Thank you. Thank you.
diocese comes in then to be the state, and they remove some of the furnishings of the church and put them in storage, and they're often there available then to new churches being built. We turn over to the real estate office next week, and they try to salvage what's usable and try to sell the church to generate income to keep the school going. Their big project is to keep the school going. We think we can figure out some financing for hopefully 5 years. So St. Ethelreda will stay as a presence in the community as a school. The worshiping community will be many of them moving over to St. Kilian. Blessed are you, Father God. In this place, we have known your love, and we trust our future to your care. And as we gather at the baptismal, we thank you, Lord, as we remember all the baptisms celebrated here in this church. We praise you for the life of faith given to all who have passed through the waters of life at this time. And then at the confessional, we're pretty well worn out, everybody. Let us remember, Lord, the times when we have been forgiven, been comforted and consoled in the sacrament of penance or reconciliation. We thank and praise you for the healing and the reconciling love given through this sacrament. The stations of the cross, we remember the generations of prayer and devotion that these sacred images have inspired. We thank you for inspiring us, in us, true devotion to Jesus' way of the cross. At the pulpit, we remember the power of God's word, both proclaimed in scripture and preaching. We thank you for the praise, we thank you and we praise you for your holy word, proclaimed in faith. May it echo always in our hearts and lives. We remember the times we have gathered for this sacred banquet, where we have worshiped, for our first communion celebration, the feast days of our saints and martyrs, the weddings witnessed here, the funerals held here in Rome. God, you are our refuge, and our home is in you. You are greater than any temple, church, or cathedral that can be built by human hands. Yet in this place, we have met your divine majesty. This church building has been for us a place of blessing. Protect us on our way, Lord. Lead us to new friends and other faith communities. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. May your blessing be strong in our hearts and lives, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We go now to love and serve him in one another.
Thank you.